Good morning all, myself Professor Hiten Mistry, and today from SNP Adal Institute of Technology and Research Center, Anurag Bardoli. So today we are going to learn allotropy of iron carbon diagram in the subject material science and metallurgy. So now here is the first slide. So now as we see here in the initial pictures, okay, here let's take an highlighter. Okay. So here we can see the general figures of an iron which is available in the raw form and also in the finished product. Okay, so talking about the iron, okay, in an almost pure form, okay, when we are taking iron in a pure form, it is known as ingot or rock iron. So iron has very limited application like roofing in our house, duct or kitchens, drainage system in domestic and industrial uses. Then after in the refrigeration cabinets, in the stoves, washing machine, etc. Okay. In an alloyed form, talking about the alloyed form. Alloyed is what? The mixing of two or more than metal is your alloy. So now we are here mixing carbon as the first content and iron as the second content. So by combination of iron and carbon, we have an alloy. Okay. So alloy of iron carbon system is known as ferrous alloys. Okay. Now they include the family of ferrous material include plain carbon steel, alloy steel, and cast iron. Now, the metal iron is primarily constituents of some most important engineering alloys, and hence it is important to study iron carbon. Depending upon the percentage of iron and carbon, the material has been classified according to different criteria. So we have to learn iron carbon diagram for the specific property of an material. So now, iron carbon diagram is also known as iron carbon phase diagram or iron carbon equilibrium diagram or iron iron carbide diagram or Fe3C diagram. Okay. So these are the basic names available for the iron carbon diagram. The name is different, the content is same. Okay. Now, depending upon percentage of carbon, the material has been classified as, suppose, the percentage of carbon is below 0.08%, then it is classified as an ingot or rock iron. Now, if we take above limit, said let's say 0.8 to 2.1, it is basically known as plain carbon steel or carbon steel, which is having limit of 0.8 to 2.1. Same it is for the other percentage like chromium, vanadium, molybdenum, etc. alloy steel. It is having the percentage of carbon of 2.1 to 6.67 percentage. It falls under the category of chromium, vanadium, molybdenum, etc. And above, if we go above 6.67 percentage of carbon, then it is comes into the family of pig iron. Okay. So now, generally, all the elements is come under the percentage of 6.67. So depending upon that percentage of carbon, the various material has been classified. Okay. Now, our next topic is allotropy of pure iron. Okay. So now, first of all, we are going to learn polymorphism. Okay. So now, what is polymorphism? Polymorphism is a physical phenomenon where a material may have more than one crystal structure. Okay. Now, we have already learned the crystal structure in the second chapter. Okay, so now see the various crystal structure as BCC, FCC, HCP, etc. These are the various form of crystal structure available in a material. Okay, so now as we see here, okay, so these are the, sorry, okay. Okay, so as we see here in the figure, therefore, the crystal structure may change with the change in temperature or external pressure. The crystal structure, depending upon the external pressure and temperature, it may vary with respect to material to material. If the change in structure is reversible, understand, the make predicts going clear. If the change in structure is reversible, then the polymorphism change is known as allotropy. Okay, so this is the main point. If the change of structure is reversible, for example, let's say we have from the initial stage, we have BCC structure. After some period of change in temperature and pressure, it may change into FCC. Again, from some temperature and addition of some temperature and pressure, it may change to HCP. Again, addition of some temperature and pressure, it may might be changed into BCC again with magnetic property. Okay, so what does the word polymorphism means? Okay, it is a physical phenomenon when there is a material may have one or more than crystal structure. So talking about ion, okay, so ion, your ion in the shoot to say, okay, if at a specific temperature we can find that it has a BCC structure, at some part of temperature and pressure it had FCC structure, again HCP structure and BCC structure with magnetic particle density. So as we see here, the various property of crystal structure change from BCC to FCC to HCP to BCC again. Okay, so this change in structure is known as polymorphism, and if the change in structure is reversible, okay, reversible, then it is known as allotropy. Okay, so basically it is known as an allotropy. Now, one familiar example is found in a carbon, which is basically in a graphite form. Okay, so what does it do? Okay, it is a stable polymorph or formed at an ambient temperature condition where diamond is at the extremely high condition. Okay, so talking about the carbon, it basically it forms carbon as a main constituent of graphite, which is stable monophysm and form at ambient temperature, it's general temperature, and whereas diamond is formed at an extremely high temperature. The best example of allotropy of iron. Okay, so now as we see here, let's say in the figure, so here is the figure of allotropy of iron. So now as we see here, in the y axis, in the vertical axis, we have temperature in a degree Celsius and we have time in the horizontal axis. Okay, so now as we see here, so as we increase from down to up, the temperature is increasing. So at the initial state it is 768, after that there is a 910, after that 1404 and 1539. Okay, now we are going to learn allotropy of pure iron, so we are only talking about allotropy of pure iron. Okay, now when we are heating iron at a degree of 1539, at a temperature of above 1500 degree, so but obvious it will be having its melting point and the metal is available in a liquid form. Okay, so now after that, at that point of time, after that we are rejecting heat from the metal. As we solidify the metal, we are letting it to reject heat from it. After that the temperature become decreases. So as we have learned, there is an phase change phenomenon occurred at this point of time. Okay, so what does it happen at this horizontal axis? Okay, so at particular this point of time, there is a rejection of latent heat. Okay, so there is a rejection of latent heat from a particular constant temperature. After that, there is a decremental temperature in graph, which shows that again there is a change in a structure. So as we have in a liquid form, after some solidification start, it form delta ion. Okay, which is having structure of BCC structure for a particular period of time. After some after at that 1404 degree, again the phase change will occur and latent heat come into picture. Okay, and same as it is, delta ion is formed at the initial state. After that there is an again decrease, rejection of heat, by that the temperature has been decreased, and again we have found that the formation of delta ion is changed to gamma ion. Delta ion is basically changed to gamma ion, and the main thing is what, there is a change in crystal structure. So initially it was in BCC structure, now it is in FCC structure. And the main thing is that the property is of a non-magnetic type of property. Understand, basically the range between 910 degree Celsius and 410 degree Celsius is basically known as an austenite structure. Okay, now again same phenomenon will happen. There is an increase in solidification with respect to time. Again, the gamma ion is changed to alpha ion. Okay, so gamma is again changed to alpha ion. same as it is, FCC ion is again, crystal structure is again changed to BCC, okay, and the property remains same. It will be non-magnetic at a particular temperature period of 768 and 910 degrees Celsius, okay. Now, as the temperature decreases, at the last stage, the phenomenon change such as alpha ion remain alpha ion, crystal structure remain crystal structure, but we have found a property change in a non-magnetic to magnetic. Okay, and range between 0 degrees Celsius to 786 degrees Celsius is basically known as a ferrite material. Okay, so as we seen earlier in the figure, the pure ion is available in the liquid form at a 1539 degree. After that, there is a decremental. After that, we are let the metal to be solidified, and as we have find that the liquid metal is converted is starting to solidify, and at the initial state of solidify, it will form a delta ion which is having BCC structure. After some period of time, the structure change and it will become to gamma ion which is having FCC structure and having property of non-magnetic structure. Basically, that structure is known as an austenitic structure. After that, after some period of time at a curing temperature, the gamma ion is changed to alpha ion and the structure is also changed from FCC to BCC, and the property remains same, which is magnetic in the austenite, and same it is for the non-magnetic property. After that, again the process continues and the alpha ion remains same and the structure is also remains same, but there is a change in magnetic property. The, as we seen in the seven, in the between the range of 768 to 910, it shows a non-magnetic property, and in the region 0 to 768 we can found that there is a magnetic property comes into picture of an ion. Okay, so this is the basically allotropy of an ion from the liquid state, from at a high temperature to low temperature. Okay, so this is the basics criteria for allotropy of an ion. Okay, now when the ion is crystallized at 1539 degrees Celsius, it is a BCC structure which is having delta ion. At 1440 structure, it is having FCC structure which is gamma ion, and at 910 degree it again become BCC, but there is a change in a alpha ion or ferritic structure. Okay, so basically this is a pure form of allotropy of an ion. Okay, now we are going to learn ion carbon phase diagram. Okay, so this is the most important topic of an subject and mostly asked in the examination, so we are going to highlight this ion carbon diagram. Okay, now okay, so this is the ion carbon diagram. Don't hesitate, just chill, waiting for my instruction. Don't look over here and there, just waiting for my command. As we go according to that, it will be so easy for us to understand the various ion carbon diagram. Okay, as we see in the ion carbon diagram, in the y axis we have temperature, okay, and in the x axis we have composition of percentage of weight. Okay, and on that and the various stems are been there, various sections are been there. So now, first of all, so what does we see? The following phases are involved in the transformation occurring to ion carbon alloy. So we are going to learn various phases that available in the ion carbon diagram. Okay, so as we see here, here is a liquid stage. Okay, so as we see here, so it is a liquidious solution of ion carbon diagram. Okay, so we are going to cover it with now. Chalu thiyo, now chalu thiyo.